last year, as you know, we had some tragedies in stormwater season from people just not being in the right place at the right time. And what people need to understand is even a brief storm can be a very dangerous thing. Taking your car into any water at all is a bad idea. Cars will float in less than a foot of water. Most of the vehicles we pulled out of ponds last year were pickup trucks and SUVs. They are no safer than a car. Turn around, don't drown is a very, very serious thing, and I can't say enough about it. In the city of El Paso, like many cities, our streets are actually designed to carry water. The street you're standing on is designed to carry stormwater. It carries it to this point and into this pond. And so in a very bad situation, and in a flood situation, if the water gets high, it's a very dangerous place to be. We work daily trying to keep these things in service and clean. We have a lot of projects that we're working on right now. This pond is actually going to be expanded. Work will start within the next few days on an expansion of this pond and then several other projects around it. So we're continually working to upgrade the system, to make the system better, to make the system stronger. But no matter what, you can't always predict how severe an event's going to be. And the important thing is for people to be aware and to be safe.
And so one of the hazards we have is cars trying to get home, trying to get to the residence, trying to get through water because, you know, for whatever reason, they feel it's not a hazard. But what they don't understand is the force of the water. The streets are designed to move the water. That is their intent. And so a lot of areas shuttle the water to the ponding areas that you see behind me. That's what they're designed for. But they are an attraction to the kids. And so we ask parents to keep track of your kids, to make sure that they are accounted for at all times. And this goes for adults too. We had a lot of adults that were getting very close to a very dangerous situation, and they think that the rain has passed, that the water situation is over. What they don't understand is that the water comes off the mountain also. So just because the water's passed through your area doesn't mean that the residual water coming off the mountain is gonna come through your community. So please be aware of the situation. Understand that you're putting yourselves in danger, and also our rescue team is putting themselves in a situation where we're there to try and help you. But at the same time, we're putting ourselves in that same predicament. So please stay away from the waters and turn around, don't drown.